Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I was out of breath then, I don't know why. Today I'm going to take a look at some viral skincare products and see if they are, in my opinion, worth the purchase, worth the virality, or whether it's just brands paying for ads like it usually is. Which is fine, but let's not call it viral when it's just launched, you know? Now, this is a product I've seen everywhere, and it's purely because of the amount of adverts that I've seen people do of this product. This is the Clarins Cryo-Flash Cream Mask, purchased with my own money. A lot of people whose content I really like and whose reviews I trust have done sponsorships for this brand. I've not used Clarins I've never used Clarins. Oh my God. Clarins, I've never used because to me it's a very old school brand, you know, that your like older relatives would use. And I don't really see, you know, I don't know. I feel like it's purposely targeted at a more mature audience. But when I saw this Cryo-Flash cream mask, I really wanted to try it because, again, with my rosacea and that term inflammaging, cryotherapy is meant to be good for calming all that down, stopping redness, inflammation. But this mask in particular says, let me read it here. The intensive 10-minute cooling cream face mask inspired by the latest cryotherapy techniques, pores are visibly minimized, skin feels firmer, and radiance is restored. They say that it's ideal for all skin types and it's an icy cold cream, a 10-minute mask, and they say that cryo started technology innovation. Now, bear in mind that these studies and this innovation comes from Clarins himself. It's not an independent study, it's their own findings in-house. Clarins Laboratories have developed a dual molecular and plant technology capable of reproducing the mechanisms of cold on the skin, MGA molecule derived from menthol and evening primrose extract, Clarins exclusive organic plant. I don't think evening primrose is exclusive to Clarins. That's an odd statement. Or maybe they've trademarked it. I don't know. So how does this work? They say that colder skin means stronger skin. Sending a shot of calcium to the heart of each keratinocyte. Keratinocyte. Cell renewing the epidermis from within. I'll be honest with you. I don't know how much of this is fake science jargon. But I did do my own in-house experiment. When you apply this cream, it is instantly cooling. Really, that is down to the menthol. It does have menthol in here, which really cools the skin. When you first apply it, you don't really feel it. Then after a while, it kind of becomes a little bit stingy. I don't like menthol in my skincare because of for that reason. It doesn't, to me, feel like a cooling sensation. It feels like a sting. It feels like my skin has pins and needles. Now, I have my own thermal camera thing, right? So here is my face before. As you can see to the side, the more yellow and orange something is, the warmer it is, the more purple to blue something is, the cooler it is. And you can actually see the temperatures. Bearing in mind, this is one of the hottest days of the year so far. And after 10 minutes, you can see that it really has cooled down my skin. And my skin did feel cool after. Even when I took it off, my skin was still, that menthol feeling was gone, but the cooling sensation was still there. And I will say after about 5 minutes, redness had gone down a fair bit too. What I did then the next evening, when it was around about the same temperature, is just use a normal moisturizer. I got a moisturizer that was the same kind of texture as this mask with no cooling kind of claims. It's just a nice gel cream ceramide moisturizer. I left it on my skin for 10 minutes and look how much cooler my skin looks and felt. It felt pretty much the same without that stinging sensation. Redness had gone down. I kind of just allowed this moisturizer to sit on my skin and soak in rather than just rubbing it in straight away. But my skin was so much cooler. So if we're talking about cooling down the skin, I feel like my general moisturizer did just as good a job for actually cooling down the skin. And whilst the menthol-y cold thing might be a bit more of a gimmick, it may be down more to the actual ingredients within the mask that help with the lifting, the firming, whatever it is that they're claiming effects. Menthol, whilst it can be irritating in some ways, I believe the way it's formulated into this particular product is more just a cooling sensation and even anti-inflammatory. This is a nice luxury to have. I wouldn't say I will keep buying it, to cool down my skin, seeing as I do know my moisturizers do just as good a job. Even like a cold mask in the fridge, even just a sheet mask straight out the pack, also cools down my skin. This gives you that kind of like, what's the word, placebo effect, because you feel it as well. You're like, oh my God, it's tingling, it's cooling, it must be working. And maybe over a period of time, this can have some really nice lifting and firming effects on your skin. I'm gonna keep using it because it was fucking expensive. It was like 50 quid. So maybe in a month's time or so, I might have some updates for you. But I don't really enjoy the feeling of stingy menthol on my skin. I'm so distracted today. Sorry, I'm trying to film this video and say things, but I live in the country, this complete tangent, and it's really hot this week. So I'm trying to keep my windows open for the tiny bit of breeze that is out this early in the morning. But the field opposite have just put all their manure out. So I can't have my windows open because it stinks of shit. Right, next up, I want to try the L'Oreal Paris True Match Nude Plumping Tinted Serum with 1% pure hyaluronic acid. Now, this is technically makeup, I believe, but it's also technically skincare. They say that this is a serum formulated 1% hyaluronic acid to cover like a foundation and now replump and hydrate the skin in 1 hour, available in 10 shades, with a luminous finish for natural looking skin. Now, that is what I want. As someone with rosacea, I don't know if I mentioned, but I have rosacea. So when my skin flushes, I do like to try and have something on my skin that like, evens out that redness a little bit. I still like to see the redness in my skin, because I feel like my face is really flat if it's just one tone. So I don't really know how to use it, to be honest. I'm just gonna put it on my hand. Oh, the bottle is very leaky. Like it leaks very, very easily. Oh, this feels very soft. Well, I'll do one cheek so we can see this one, the difference side by side. It does feel really soft and smooth. Usually when I've tried like these tinted kind of serums, foundations before, my skin kind of feels instantly matte and powdery and dry. And within like a few minutes, my skin gets like kind of tight. Do you know what I mean? Like, oh, yes. And you can see every pore and bit of texture on my face, which obviously I don't like. You know, it emphasizes it more than anything. But this feels really genuinely hydrating, which usually when these like 2-in-1 hybrids, skincare makeup hybrids, say they're hydrating, I'm like, no, you're not. Like, you've just got hyaluronic acid in, so you're using that hydrating buzzword, you know, to complement your product. I mean, it definitely looks better on camera than it does in real life, I'll say that. This lighting isn't the most flattering anyway. I think I like that. It gives like a very natural glow. It's like a nice light coverage, which is what I like. You see the difference? With it, without it. I think I like that. I really quite like that. But look, it's also just leaking everywhere. It's very messy. Very messy. Like, the product doesn't stay in the pipette. And then it's also like covering the pipette on the outside as well. So it's very messy, very leaky, very fluidy, which I think it kind of needs to be this like skincare hybrid. I really don't dislike that. I need to tidy it up a bit. It's all in my beard line. Honestly, I've tried better tints, like the Summer Fridays. Where's this one? This Summer Fridays one is really, really nice and really fluidy, without that kind of dry powderiness. But maybe that's something you're just going to get because it's makeup. But I like that for the price and accessibility. I think that's pretty good. I'm not going to lie. Next up, we have the Charlotte Tilbury Charlotte's Magic Water Cream. So this is supposed to be a more lightweight, oily skin-friendly version of her magic cream. They say it's a new fragrance-free gel cream moisturizer for 100-hour hydration and dewy fresh water glow. Darlings, your skin is thirsty. Drench your skin with 100-hour hydration with new Charlotte's Magic Water Cream. My immediate skin revival gel cream moisturizer. Why am I struggling with this? It's very clearly written. Gel cream moisturizer for a dewy glass-like fresh water glow. They say a lightweight, bouncy gel cream formula that smooths and plumps the look of your complexion and helps balance thirsty, dehydrated skin. They say in just 28 seconds, pores appear reduced by 54%. Skin tone appears more even by 69%. I can tell you that's a lie. In 28 seconds, that's not going to happen. This is one of my gripes with Charlotte Tilbury, is this kind of like these old fashioned kind of like snake oil claims. Nothing's going to happen in just 28 seconds. Maybe hyaluronic acid is going to make your skin dewier and plumper. Tinted serums, you know, all that kind of stuff are going to give these like temporary effects, but you're not going to see your pores reduced by 54% in just 28 seconds. Like, let's not lie. You've already got an iconic brand. So I've been using this since its release, actually. I ordered it myself. I'm not on their PR list, as you can tell. It's really fucking nice. And I'll be honest with you, I really hate to say it, because I don't believe you should ever have to pay so much money for skincare. This was £26 and it's tiny. Like, I thought I made a mistake and got a sample. And their bigger version, their 50 milliliters, is £79. And I do not think that that Charlotte Tilbury's skincare especially is worth those markup prices. What I will say is this is a really, really nice moisturizer. It's really nice. It feels light and like dewy and cloudy on the skin. Like, you put it on and your skin feels a lot cooler. Your skin looks like... Do you know what I hate about like these dewy, glowy skin moisturizers? That sometimes they can just look a little bit greasy on your face, but you put this on and your skin does look dewy and glowy. It feels like it settles well into the skin almost immediately without being a typical full oily skin cream, in the sense that it's, you know, very alcohol heavy, in the sense that everything just kind of sinks into your skin and then evaporates off. You can feel the moisture and hydration and nourishment 12 hours later. When I wake up, my skin feels great. My skin feels so good without being one of those really thick creams that I usually like to use in the evening. So for like summer nights or winter days for my oily T-zone, this unfortunately is going to be perfect. It's a really nice, like nice is the word for it. Like, your feet and you're like you use it and you're like, oh God, this is really fucking good. What I will say is this has been advertised as something for people with oily skin. And whilst this doesn't feel greasy on the skin, I feel like during the day, if I use this in the morning, my oily T-zone will struggle producing oils because it's not that light. It's not like when you think of water cream, you think of Lotus Revectin cream, their Verse Dewpoint like cream, right? During the day, they are perfect for oily skin because they don't feel heavy in any way. Whilst this does sink really nicely into the skin, there's still a little something there that I do think kind of is what keeps your skin feel moisturized throughout the night. If you do have very oily skin, your oils are going to react to this. I feel like it's going to be a little bit heavy for like the tiniest bit. So it's not light enough, in my opinion, to be called a water cream in the sense of what we all know a water cream to be. Is it a nice lightweight moisturizer? Yes, a very, very nice lightweight moisturizer. Finally, we have the Naked Sundays Glow and Go Lip Oil. So this is an SPF 50, which is great. I actually really like Naked Sundays. I kind of forgot about them for a bit, but I love their sunscreens. Their zinc one isn't too great. I used it in a video and I really thought I liked it. And then later on, it was all balling up in my hairline. But this one is their coconut flavor, I believe the clear one is, which has hyaluronic acid, watermelon extract for antioxidants, kakadu plum, which is a nice vitamin C. Now, kakadu plum, vitamin C, again, for antioxidants, which we love with a sunscreen. Now, here's my review. I've been using it for a few days, and it goes on very glossy, very, very glossy. And I do feel like for the amount you have to use, it may be too glossy for some. It's very sticky. It is very, very sticky. Can see. And very glossy. So I do feel like this might be nice under makeup, maybe like a gloss or something, or like lipstick. I don't know how lipstick would perform over the top of it. Tastes like sunscreen, very much tastes like sunscreen. I do not think the coconut helps that, because that coconut reminds me of like the SPF oils and like old fashioned sunscreen, where I feel like coconut was the flavor, like Malibu. Was it Malibu Sun? Whatever that brand is, I'll put it here. Hawaiian Tropic, something like that. It reminds you of that, like a very old fashioned sunscreen. They do have other flavors. But honestly, I've been using it because I'm fine with it. After a good 5 minutes, that sunscreen taste kind of goes. It does leave. And the stickiness does calm down. I feel like you need to give it a minute and just kind of do this. However, it's very, very glossy. The lights are definitely emphasizing the gloss. But is nice. I do like Naked Sunday. I'm going to use it. I will continue to use it up. And I'll definitely check out their other sunscreens. They have an amazing array of sunscreen. But yes, let me know if you've used any of these products before. If you were surprised by any of them, let me know in the comments down below. You can watch some more product reviews here. Turn down a light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.